I'm Kiesha Arielle and I'm the founder of Hair We Gro, and today we are gonna talk all about mineral oils. We are gonna find out what mineral oils are, how to identify mineral oils in our hair and beauty products, and also find out why it's not good for our hair and skin. So with no further ado, sit tight and let's jump right into today's video. Okay, so like many of you, I once was oblivious to what mineral oils are. For sure, I did not know how to identify mineral oils in hair and beauty products. But with some research, I was able to find out that information, and I would like to share that with you so that you can identify these things in your hair and beauty products. And also, I will be sharing with you why it's not good for us at all. So with that, I'm gonna pick up my phone where I got all my notes, and I'm gonna read through what mineral oils are, and we're gonna talk about the different types of mineral oils, and also I will be telling you how to identify them, and of course, why it's not good for our hair and skin. Okay, so let's get into it. So what are mineral oils? Mineral oils are clear, colorless, or pale yellow liquid substances derived from petroleum. They are a type of hydrocarbon oil and are typically used for various industrial and commercial purposes. So clearly, mineral oil is petroleum, and we all have petroleum in our home. I mean, I'm pretty sure we do. Some Vaseline, you all heard about Vaseline. Now, I did not know petroleum was mineral oil. So you live and you learn every single day. So we can identify what it is. Now, there are different kinds of petroleum, because they break it down at certain levels when they add certain amount of heat to it, and it they use it in different industries, as mentioned, industrial and commercial. So we're gonna identify now the different kinds of petroleum, because clearly we have them in our homes that we'll use on if someone shaved, or some, a baby shaved, or you're shaved or anything like that, or if there's a burn and you want to cover it. So we understand how thick it can be, right? But you can also heat it for it to get a little less viscous, or be a little less viscous, right? So let's identify the different types of mineral oils. Now, there are six types of mineral oils, but there are also two main types that you will see a lot of people use more in the industrial and the commercial setting. So let's jump right into those. So you have, amongst the two main ones are liquid paraffin and white mineral oil. Now, liquid paraffin, this type of mineral oil is highly refined and is often used in cosmetics, pharmaceuticals, and as a laxative. It's also used in various industrial applications such as lubricants and cooling fluids. Now, in terms of white mineral oil is a more refined and purified form of mineral oil. It is commonly used in the food industry for products like food grade lubricants, and is also found in personal care products, including baby oil and skin lotions. So as we can see here, white mineral oil is what is mostly used in the hair and beauty industry, or you know, body care, personal care, right? So now it continues to say, mineral oils have low reactivity and are prized for their stability and lubricating properties. However, they should not be ingested or used on certain materials such as rubber, as they can cause deterioration or other adverse effects. Now, that part right there where it says it's not supposed to be ingested because it can cause adverse effects. Now, when you put in petroleum jelly or any form of mineral oil, because again, that's what it is, it goes into your skin or into your hair shaft. Now, I know a lot of people make it out like your hair is dead, which I highly disagree with, because if your hair strands were dead, how is it possible to keep something that is dead healthy? you know, you hear about healthy hair strands. So if it's dead, then how could it be healthy? You can't be dead and healthy and still thrive. So as mentioned, your hair strands are not dead, because you cannot keep something that is dead healthy and allow it to thrive. Now, the point I'm making here is simply that when you put mineral oils onto your skin or your hair, it's quote unquote ingested into your body. Same as, you know, putting it in your mouth. You don't only ingest things by putting it in your mouth. Your body absorbs things, i.e. ingesting it into your bloodstream. Now, also when it comes to your hair, again, in, you know, going off of this thing that your hair strand is not dead, if it was dead, your hair cuticles wouldn't have, you know, motion in it in order to rise and open to allow for moisture to get inside of your hair strands to go to the medulla, where most of the moisture component of your hair is. So when you're putting mineral oils onto your hair shaft, on your hair shaft now, this is going to cause it to suffocate because it's so heavy, and it's going to literally cause the cuticles to be more like closed, you know, something very heavy on top of your hair strands, and your cuticles will not allow for moisture to get into your hair. So this is one of the reasons as to why mineral oils is not good for your hair or for your skin. Now again, there are different levels of it where it can be absorbed more quickly into your hair or your skin, in comparison to if you were to look at your Vaseline in your home, that's not gonna get absorbed directly into your skin as quick as if it was like more refined and more less viscous, if you understand what I'm trying to say here. But we are gonna continue identifying the other four mineral oils. Now, and this is just for educational purposes, okay? Now you have the industrial mineral oil, and it says these are heavier, less refined mineral oils used for industrial purposes, such as in machinery, as hydrochloric fluids, and in metal working applications. Did I say hydrochloric? I meant hydraulic. Hydraulic fluids. Also, you have transformer oil. Mineral oil, so the transformer oil, mineral oil, is used as an insulating and cooling medium in electrical transformers to dissipate heat and insulate electrical components. Next, you have cutting oils. So you have the cutting oil, mineral oils are used as cutting fluids in machining processes to lubricate and cool cutting tools and work pieces during metalworking. And last but not least, you have gear oil, mineral oils, which are used as lubricants in gearboxes and transmission system to reduce friction and wear. So those four was just more so for educational purposes, so you understand different forms of mineral oils, right? But the ones that is used in the hair and beauty industry is the white mineral oil. Again, they have it at different levels, and again, it should not be ingested into the body, okay? Because it causes adverse effects. Now, of course, we're here talking about our hair, and as mentioned, it will cause your hair to be less breathable, right? And it also causes buildup. Now, think about it. No matter how viscous it is, right, or thick, let us just use a more simpler word, how thick it is or thin it is, it should not be ingested. Now, even if you're putting that onto your hair, it is still too heavy for your hair strands, and it's not going to allow for other nutritious products, like, for example, our Hair We Gro hair oil that got all lovely nutrients in it to help your hair to thrive and to grow, it won't allow for the nutrients from oils such as these to get into your hair strands or into your scalp. So mineral oils are not good. It causes buildup and it doesn't allow your skin or your hair to breathe. It puts a barrier on top of your hair strands and also on top of your skin that doesn't allow it to breathe more freely. So this is why we don't use any mineral oils in our products, whether it's our hair and body butters or our hair oil, because we want to allow for a light, non-greasy, non-buildup environment. I was kind of like thinking, what am I supposed to say here? But yeah, so we create a nice, light, non-grease environment for your hair and scalp so that it can actually thrive. Now, in addition to causing the hair to feel weighed down because it's too heavy for your hair strands or not breathable, there are other reasons why mineral oils is not good for your hair. Again, also I mentioned that it blocks nutrients from absorbing into your hair and your scalp and also your skin. You know, we're going to discuss other ways in which mineral oils can adversely affect your hair and skin. So more notes here. Let me just go back to the top of my notes because I know I kind of jumped into some of these points here, but I'm going to go back to the top so that we can, you know, discuss it as each point. So mineral oils are often considered less desirable for hair for several reasons, such as weight and greasiness. Again, like I mentioned, it puts this barrier onto your hair and it makes it very greasy because of, no matter how thick or thin it is, it causes this greasy, nasty effect and it weighs down your hair. So they're very heavy and can make the hair feel greasy and weighed down, and this can lead to a lack of volume and manageability. Also, buildup. Mineral oil can create a barrier on the hair and scalp that may not be easily removed by regular shampoos. This can lead to product buildup, making the hair look dull and requiring more intensive cleansing to remove the residue. So now, if you are using products with mineral oils in it, you might find that you have to clarify your hair more often, and clarifying shampoo should not be used very often on the hair, probably once a month. So again, this is why it's important to identify what mineral oils are and what products they are in so you can avoid them if you don't want your hair to feel weighed down and also, you know, have any product buildup. Now, next, again, mention lack of nutritional benefits, right? Mineral oil does not provide any nutritional benefits to the hair whatsoever, okay? Unlike natural oils, like our Hair We Gro hair oils that also have coconut oil, we have olive oil, we have castor oil in it. So unlike natural oils as such, which can nourish and moisturize the hair, mineral oil merely forms a barrier on the surface without penetrating the shaft. So it doesn't do anything for your hair, okay? It blocks all the nutrients that could possibly help your hair to thrive. So we want to avoid mineral oils. Also, potential for dryness. So some people may find that mineral oils seal in moisture temporarily, okay, but can also lead to dryness over time as it can block the hair's ability to absorb moisture from the environment, which we're going to also talk about shrinkage, because I know a lot of us are, you know, shy and don't want, and while we shy away from shrinkage, we don't want to experience shrinkage. I understand, but at the same time, shrinkage is a way of telling you that your hair is healthy. So some people might go, oh yeah, let me jump on this mineral oil because it will allow for my hair to reject moisture from the air, but that's not always good. And lastly, allergic reactions, okay? It says here, or I have here, while rare, some individuals may experience allergic reactions or scalp irritation when using products containing mineral oil. So here we are, and now we understand why mineral oil is absolutely not good for our hair. It causes dryness, it can have allergic reaction or scalp irritation. No nutritional benefits, absolutely not, right? And also buildup, and also it weighs down the hair. Not good. We don't want that. Now, let us talk about what are mineral oils. So when you pick up a product, when you see that, you can say, that's mineral oil, I do not want that. So let's discuss that further. So during my research, I wanted to know, what are mineral oils? Like, how do I look at the labels and identify mineral oils? Now, I was able to find a list of mineral oils which L'Oreal actually use in their products. And L'Oreal also is one of those big corporations that is behind a lot of hair and beauty products for everyone. So if you were to pick up a product, this is what you will look at or look out for, okay? These are some examples, all right? Now, let me tell you, I may not be able to pronounce these words, so I'll probably have it on screen so you can attempt the pronunciation, but here we are. So, some of the names you can find mineral oils under is either mineral oil, very blatant, or paraffinum liquidum, petrolatum, cera microcrystallina, microcrystalline wax, ozocarite, cerisine isoparaffin, paraffin, and synthetic wax. So these are some examples what you will see on a product, and you can identify, okay, that's mineral oil, I do not need it on my hair or on my skin. Again, mineral oil is not good for our hair or our skin, and this is why we do not use them in any of our products. All our products have natural oils and natural butters, and nothing to weigh down your hair or, you know, block the absorption of nutrients or moisture, whether it's in your skin or in your hair. So I hope you guys found this video very helpful and would love to try some of our products for yourself. If so, visit our website, hairwegro.store. Get your hands on our products and let us know how you love it. And also, moving forward, you can now identify what mineral oils are, why it's not good for our hair, and you can also explain to someone who asks you what are mineral oils, and you can confidently say petroleum jelly. So with that, I hope you found today's video very informative, and until the next one, we will be right back here with another video.